Welcome to a lesson on describing the meaning of a fraction. In the first problem, we're asked what does 2/7 mean? Use diagrams or words to explain. If we want to diagram 2/7 and we think of this rectangle as one whole, we would cut or partition the rectangle into 7 equal parts or pieces and then shade 2 of them. So to cut or partition this rectangle into 7 equal parts or pieces, it would look like this, and then we shade 2 of the 7 parts. This diagram or model is one way to express the meaning of 2/7. We can also think of 2/7 as 2 out of 7. Using the idea of copying, notice that one piece is equal to 1/7, so we can think of 2/7 as 2 copies of 1/7. We can also think of 2/7 as we have 7 total parts and are referring to 2 of them. A fraction bar means division, so 2/7 also means 2 divided by 7. We can also express ratios in fraction form, which means 2/7 can mean the ratio of 2 to 7. Now we'd have to be careful about modeling the ratio of 2 to 7. If we wanted to use this model for the ratio of 2 to 7, we would have to specify this is the ratio of the shaded parts to the total number of parts. Notice how there are 2 shaded parts and a total of 7 parts. A ratio can be a comparison of part to whole, whole to part, or part to part. So we would have to be careful about modeling the ratio of 2 to 7. Let's look at another example. We have a whole pizza that we want to share among 8 people equally. How much of the pizza would each person get? A. Draw and label a diagram. B. Name each piece using the appropriate wording. And C. Describe what process was used. So if there are 8 people and we want to share the pizza equally, we need to cut or partition the pizza into 8 equal parts or pieces, which would look like this. Notice each part or piece is 1/8 of the pizza. So for the label, we'll label each piece as 1/8. One piece would be 1 copy of 1/8. 2 pieces would be 2 copies of 1/8. 3 pieces would be 3 copies of 1/8, and so on. So to answer the question, how much of the whole pizza would each person get? The answer is 1/8 of the pizza. We've already drawn and labeled the diagram. We've also named each piece. Let's go ahead and describe what process we used. We cut the pizza into 8 equal-sized parts. Each part is 1/8 of the pizza. Now for the last question, using the original 8 pieces, consider reassembling the pieces back together. How many copies of the pieces are required to make the whole pizza? Well, because each piece is 1/8 of the pizza, it takes 8 copies of the pieces, where each piece is 1/8 of the pizza, to make one whole pizza. So it takes 8 copies of the pieces, which are 1/8 of the pizza, to make one whole pizza. I hope you found this helpful.